I don't wanna lose you. Wake up, this ain't just a thing that you give up, don't you say that I'd be better off, still lost, help and wondering, better off, without you, boy, don't just leave me hanging on, don't just leave me hanging on. The little things you do to me, I take it. I want to show you everything inside of me. It's crazy beats that my feet are stuck here against the pavement. I want to break free. I want to make it closer to your eyes, your attention, before you pass me by. Don't just leave me hanging on. Back up, take another chance. Don't you mess up, I don't wanna lose you. Wake up, this ain't just a thing that you give up, don't you say that.
Hi guys, we're gonna go ahead and get started. I know people are still kind of popping on, so couple things before we get going. Welcome to the call. I feel really weird right now. I think mostly because this is a really exciting thing. It's something that I've been wanting to do for a really long time. I just haven't done it. And so I'm excited to get it going, and I've been praying all week to figure out, you know, the right things to say. And I feel like it's going to be good. If you guys are on the chat, as you have questions, as we kind of go through the presentation, if you're not seeing the slides or if you have questions or whatever, post them in the chat. And I've got some coaches online to kind of answer those questions as you guys go. And hopefully your sponsor or the person that invited you to the call is on the call with you. So what I'm going to ask at the very end is for you guys to get with the person that invited you and chat further any questions or next steps or whatever from this point on. So I just wanted to give you guys a quick breakdown of what we're going to go over on this call. So it's mostly going to be what coaching is, what and why. The how comes later if this is something that you decide is for you or not. So I don't want you focused so much on how you're going to do this or how you're going to reach your goals or how you're going to accomplish it. Tonight we're really just going to talk about what it is. I'm going to touch a little bit on how we do what we do and what coaching actually is about. So it'll answer some of those questions naturally, and we'll go over some of the nitty-gritties of it, some common objections that I get that I think are important to just kind of knock out right from the get-go, and we'll talk a little bit about goal setting at the very end. So get out your paper. Smart people take notes. So write down your questions kind of as we go. I'm just going to take 15 minutes or so and talk about sort of my journey and my story and how I got into this, and then we'll go into that other stuff. So let's get started. This is like the funny part of the call, because you're probably like, okay, thank you for the invite, but what actually is coaching? So I wanted to kind of give a good answer to that question before we continue, so that you know what we're talking about as we go through the call. So coaching is basically just living fit out loud for a living. It really is as simple as that. It's just about taking your journey that you're already doing. Most of you are probably working out, some probably with Beachbody products, some probably not. But it's really people who are interested in living a fitness and healthy lifestyle, and they understand the importance of that in their life and really wanting to help other people kind of grasp that concept and start doing it themselves. So it's just living fit out loud instead of sort of like doing your workouts and not posting about it online or social media. You post about it, and you know, it's sometimes for the occasional person that needs to see that in order to get their own journey started, that inspiration or that motivation. But largely, you guys, it's just a higher accountability for yourself. And coaching is so much about that, really lifting your life so that you're able to lift other people's. It's also about goal setting and really getting good at that and really getting focused in on what you want out of your life so that you can have intentional success and you can live an intentional life instead of just sort of, you know, meandering through it. So those are the three things that I personally love the most about coaching and what it's brought to my life. It's really given me some direction, some purpose, and some accountability, which I think is awesome. So here's a story that I hate talking about, but I'm telling you anyway. And my coaches have heard this a billion times, but hopefully it'll be something that will inspire you guys or give you little nuggets to help you either progress past some obstacles that you have or help you understand that this is really just for anybody that decides to commit to it. So I am the CEO of Team Lift. All of my coaches are CEOs of their own companies as well. And when you become a coach, you kind of become the CEO of your own company. Yeah, understand. And that's something that you'll grow into and that you'll grasp as we teach you how to do this and really, you know, become an entrepreneur and run a business. But I, from the get-go, like to welcome our new coaches as CEOs because it's important to understand that your success is 100% up to you. It's your business. It's your schedule. It's your time frame. It's whatever you want to make out of it. So for me, I just wanted to give you guys a little rundown of what my what's going through a lot of your minds right now, and I just want to put that on at ease. So for me, when I very first started coaching, it was 5 years ago in January, actually, and I was a very shy, sort of introverted person. I didn't have any self-confidence at the time. And I, to be honest with you guys, I hadn't really had a lot of self-confidence in my whole life. It wasn't just that year before coaching. It was really just sort of me trying to figure out who I was and just, you know, very affected by comparison and seeing all these people doing these amazing things and really getting stuck in my own head and holding myself back. You know, I was depressed. I was suffering a little bit from postpartum depression. I had some physical ailments from my pregnancy that were kind of holding me back from working out. And, you know, my husband was in grad school. We were super broke, getting more broke and less dollars in our bank by the day. I was a brand new mom. I didn't know what I was doing. And for most of you, if you're women on the call, if you've had babies, you kind of go through, with your first, at least for me, I went through a little mourning of my previous life, of my single self, which I think you just kind of go through. It's a transition trying to figure out how to go from just being an individual to somebody that is now a full-time caretaker and has someone who is you're responsible for. It's horrifying. So I was going through that whole experience. And I was a hairstylist by trade. So we had just moved to Arizona, and I was traveling every 6 to 8 weeks back to Utah with my baby, 10 hours there, 10 hours back in the car. Yes, with my toddler, it was a nightmare, just to kind of make ends meet and not go further and further into debt. So every dollar that we earned was going towards our living expenses and really making sure that we weren't digging ourselves deeper and deeper. So that's kind of where I started when my coach approached me about coaching, and those are all the things that sort of went through my mind, and I was like, if he even knew that this is all of the stuff that I was dealing with, I don't think he would ever have asked me if I'd ever thought about coaching. But the cool part about it was, at that time, even though I was going through all of that stuff, I was also a person who had gotten to the point where I was so depressed that I couldn't, I really had a choice to make, which was to either succeed or fail. And I couldn't fail one more time. I had to become better. I was extremely motivated to change my life, become healthier, exercise more. I really needed something to prove to myself that I could accomplish something from start to finish without quitting. I felt like I'd quit everything that I'd ever started, that I was like this amazing person not thinking about ideas, and then they would just like flit away and I would never think about them again. I was in a really desperate situation to show my son that women weren't the way that I was at the moment, somebody who was just depressed and lazy and not really setting any goals or doing anything really with my life. I was just sort of living day to day to try and survive. And so I didn't want my son to see that and think that that's how women work. That was a really big thing to do something different, to show him that I was an individual, that I did have goals, that you can still be a person even though you're a parent or a wife or a husband, and you know, you can still have a life. I wanted to take the things that I did have, which were my strengths, which was my strong work ethic, right? I didn't really understand that I had a strong work ethic until I started coaching, and then I was like, oh, I guess I do work hard. But it was because I had some things deep enough to want to change. They had to be deep enough that I was willing to work for them. So I was always a big dreamer. I always had a lot of big dreams and goals. I just didn't always know how to kind of accomplish them or what I was really meant to do. And I, you know, ever since I was a little girl, I really thought that I was put here to do something great, to do something big. But it never really landed. Like, I could never figure out what that was until I started coaching. the biggest thing that I think I had going for me at the time, beyond anything else, is just that I was ready. I was ready for a change. I was ready for opportunity. I was ready to prove to myself that I could do something different than what I was doing, better than what I was doing. And that was really an important thing for me at the time. And so I became a coach, and sort of what happened next was really interesting. The path that I took, this is really where I think God came into my journey. And I really thought about this slide a lot because I wrote the path, you know, and then I wrote Enter God and P90X, because really that's exactly how I got started. And I couldn't leave that part out of this because it's my truth and it's what it is. And I still can't talk about it. It makes me emotional. This is why I don't do this. But it's true. I prayed and prayed and prayed for God to take these burdens away from me, this depression and these physical ailments and this debt we were going into, and just put me on a path and really show me that I didn't have to live this life inhibited and depressed and this rundown sort of person, because I still felt that I was meant for something more. And it was interesting because the answer that kept coming back to me over and over and over again as I prayed to kind of figure out my path and where I should go and what I should be doing was, you just need to exercise, which at the time wasn't something I could do because of these physical ailments I was having after my pregnancy. And I remember trying to go to our little clubhouse at our apartment complex and just crying and crying when I was running on the treadmill, and I would give up and go home and, you know, cry to my husband and be like, Mike, I can't do it. He'd be like, you just have to do it. You just have to do it. And I would give up and I would pray again, and the same answer would come, you just need to exercise. And it was such a bizarre answer to my prayer, because I was praying for a lot of stuff at the time, and exercise did not seem like the answer that was going to get me out of it. But one night when I was having this really intense bout of insomnia, a P90X infomercial came on TV, and with no dollars in hand and a credit card only, I decided to just buy it, and I did. And I regretted it every single second until I started that first time, until I pushed play that first time. And I cried through the first week of workouts because of the pain. And I've been feeling that for a long time, over a year. And within a week or so, that pain started to dissipate and it started to go away. And within 2 weeks, it was gone, completely eliminated from my life. And I just remember thinking, why didn't I listen sooner? You know, why didn't I listen sooner? And I was about 4 weeks into my program when my coach asked me if I'd ever thought about coaching. And I didn't know it was a business. I didn't know what it was. All I knew was that everybody around me was doing it. And I was like, okay, whatever. And I did it. And I signed up, which I'll talk about in a second, because my sign-up process was kind of funny too. But I literally, you guys, I just surrendered everything to God, and I said, you know what, I'm going to make this coaching thing my sanctuary, and I'm going to use it to change my own life, and I'm going to use it as a platform to show everyone that I am. But really, I was just showing myself that I was changing. And it gave me something that was a daily lifeblood. It was something that I could grasp onto that was positive, that was uplifting, that allowed me to help people, which is something that I love so much. I was already in a service industry, which was hairstyling, and you're basically a therapist when you do that. Anyway, people tell you their life story, whether you want them to or not, which is kind of what happens with coaching, but I loved that. I loved working with people, and I was in such a desperate place to build a foundation of strength around me so that I could change my life. That's really what coaching became, and I started my own Facebook page completely separate from, you know, my one that had all my friends and family, and I started my business as a coach with zero friends, zero family, and I just started to change my life one day at a time and really focused forward on being positive and uplifting and adding value to people's life whenever I opened my mouth. I wanted to be the person that made them feel better when they left me. And that was a really important part of it. I finally had this coaching thing that was mine, that I controlled 100%, that I could grow as big or as small as I wanted, that was completely up to me to either succeed or fail at. And I failed a lot, which, you know, is ultimately what you have to do in order to succeed. So I use coaching as that platform, as a means to change my life. So that's part of my story. That's how I kind of got going. And I'm going to go into other little pieces of it here, but I wanted to kind of go over some questions. So you're probably wondering how I did that, right? You're probably like, okay, you signed up a Facebook page, but how did you start actually coaching? It's really simple. I did three things, and I did three things really well, and I did three things really consistently. One of them was I allowed and invited people into my journey, which I know doesn't sound like a big deal, but that's a big deal. It's a big deal putting yourself out there and really sharing that side of you openly and publicly and really allowing people to see you be vulnerable and sharing your good, your bad, your ugly, and then really just saying at the end, you know, if you're where I am, do this with me. It was me trying to build this army around me of people who were trying to do the same thing so we could strengthen and lift each other. That's it. I wasn't trying to sell anything. I wasn't trying to build a business. I was simply trying to make my life better and get people to come do it with me. That's it. I lived fit out loud. I practiced what I preached. I did my workouts every day. I worked on my diet. It wasn't perfect. I wasn't perfect. I didn't have a transformation yet. I was in the worst shape of my life, in fact, physically, mentally, spiritually, emotionally, everything you could think of. But that the point of what coaching is to show consistency that you are trying to change your life and that you're working and that you have goals. That's what people grasp onto, and that's what people see, and that's what they want in a coach. They don't need somebody that has a perfect body and perfect knowledge. They need somebody who is motivated, that they can rely on, that they know aren't going anywhere, that you're going to do this and this is your life and this is what you want and the direction that you're going, because that's what they want, right? The last thing that I did, and one of the most important things that I did, was daily personal development. Whether it was, you know, meditating or reading a book or watching a video or listening to music or watching Oprah or whatever it was at the time, I was just like the sponge that was ingesting, you know, this information, trying to pretend to be the person that I wanted to be today. Instead of saying to myself, you know, this is who I ultimately want to be, I said to myself, I'm going to be that person right now. I don't have time to wait. And so I pretended to be who I wanted to be right that second. The day I became a coach, the day I started that Facebook page, the day that I posted my first sentence as Coach Jace, I became that person that I wanted to be right then. And I think that that's such an amazing thing, because a lot of days, and I say this a lot, you got to fake it till you make it, and you fake through the days where you don't feel it and you're unmotivated and you aren't inspired, but you fake that you still are, and you just keep going and you just keep working, because eventually what happens is you aren't that old person anymore. You actually become the person that you were pretending to be to be. You become the person that you want to be, that you were working towards in the beginning. And it's an incredible sort of transition and transformation to be able to do that and share it openly with people and have them do it alongside with you. You know, it's a really cool kind of experience. And that's basically how I started coaching online. I didn't really invite a lot of my friends and family. In fact, I didn't invite any. I didn't want to build a business based around favors from those people. And I really wanted to see if it was something that I could do myself. So I built it 100% online on my phone and on my computer. And I worked every single day to just simply do these three things, allow people to be part of my journey and invite them into it. When I found somebody that was kind of where I was or working towards something too, I said, come do it with me. Let's do it together. And then I would just work out every day. I would post about it for my own accountability. And I would coach people and try and add value to those following me and those friending me and those that I was trying to network with every single day. And that's kind of how I started to do it. It might sound simple to just do your workouts and post about them for your own accountability and maybe at the end throw out a, hey, if you want to do this with me, come do it. It may sound easy to, you know, think about doing only those three things and building an entire fitness empire and really be able to live fit for a living, you know, but it really is that simple. It gets complicated when people allow the excuses to come in, which is what I want to talk about. These are the three main things that I get a lot, which are time. What about time? What about money? What about my ability, right? It's I don't have the time, or I don't have the funds, or I can't do that. And it's amazing, but those are the three things that always come up, so I want to talk about it. Time is probably the biggest excuse of the three big ones, which I just mentioned. Time is something that nobody has and everybody wants. It's the most coveted gift that there is because it's something you can never give back. And if you give it, it's something that you can't ever take back. So time is something that I think a lot of people spend time wasting thinking, well, I can't do this. I can't do this. I have this. I have this going on. I'm too busy. I'm doing this. When you should be thinking, where can I find the time? How can I make this work? Right? You have to find the time instead of making excuses for it, or it will never happen. I think about when I first thought about having a baby. It took my husband and I 5 years to decide to even have a baby because, you know, it's hard. It's hard to make those kind of decisions, but the timing was just right. You know, we didn't really have any reason not to, and we just had to do it, or else it never would have happened. And so that's kind of how coaching is. It's something that you just have to do and get into and start doing, or it's just never going to happen. You have to find the time for it and really prioritize it and take it seriously for what it can do for your life. And if you can, you know, it can be 5 minutes or 5 hours a day. Either way, you can be successful. It just depends on what you're doing with that time that you invest. The other excuse I get a lot all the time is money. I don't have the money to become a coach. I don't have the money to invest. I can't spend that. It's too much an investment. I feel selfish paying this coaching fee to start doing something just for me. I don't want to buy a program, or I don't want to buy Shakeology, or will I make money? Will I lose money? It's just all of these questions that you naturally have. And, you know, when I started, I had all of those thoughts. I literally, you guys, had $0, none. I bought P90X on an infomercial, and I literally was like, I have to make that money back, or number one, my husband's going to kill me. Number two, I'm not going to be able to pay off the credit card. So for me, it was a big deal. And just so you guys know, at the time, financially, this is where I was. I was six figures in debt, right? I was on food stamps. I was collecting more debt every single day that went by. I was working a blistering schedule, driving 6 hours or 10 hours back and forth from Arizona to Utah just to make an extra amount of money so that we wouldn't go further into debt. I literally did that for 8 months, right? Every 6 weeks, 20 hours of driving, for a 3-day workday where I bust out, 20 to 30 clients just to keep my clientele. It was crazy. It was absolutely crazy, but I still invested. And it's so important. It's such an important step, not because of the actual income itself or the money itself, but because I prioritized me. I saw the value in, I have to invest in myself if I want to progress. And it wasn't the money that I was afraid of. It was the commitment, And I think that that's something that everybody kind of has to work through and come to grips with and really understand for themselves that that's what it is. The investment so much of the time is your test to see how committed you really are. And once you have skin in the game, right? I bought that P90X on an infomercial. You better believe that thing wasn't going to sit on the shelf. I wasn't going to waste those dollars that I spent on my credit card to buy that stupid program and not do it, right? And getting through P90X from start to finish changed my entire life. My entire life. I stressed for a long time about that $180, which is what it costs off the infomercial, right, to do that program. But in the end, what it gave me was a six-figure business, a team empire, a way to be able to work from home and stay with my babies and go on vacations and do all these things with my life because I simply took that risk and I invested in one small thing in my life. And it's so important to understand that it's not just that first initial investment, right? It may seem like a mountain that you're trying to climb just to get into the coaching opportunity, but once you're there and you start to see what it really can do for your life, you'll never ever regret it. I wanted to go over sort of the investment because you guys are probably wondering what it is to even become a coach. The basic sign up to become a coach is $39.99. To some of you, that may be like, oh, it's only $40, done, right? For me, that was like $39.99. Are you freaking kidding me? I can't do that, right? And then that's a one-time fee, that $39.99. It's a setup fee. It's because Beachbody gives you 3 websites to use that are fully functioning, ready to go to help you start your business, right? The $40 is basically the hosting fee, or I'm sorry, the setup fee for those 3 websites. And then the only obligatory fee for coaching is $15.95 a month. Anything else you purchase beyond that is 100% up to you. The $15.95 is just the hosting fee for your 3 websites. So you're still investing in yourself. Beachbody has made this extremely simple and affordable so that people can build an income and an impact. They want to make change. And the coolest thing about our company is their integrity and their leadership and their goals and their drive to really change people's life, not just physically, but financially. Carl Deichler, our CEO, says our programs change hundreds and thousands of people's lives every day. It helps them find confidence. It helps them change their bodies. It helps them change their minds. But the real opportunity is in coaching. And I believe that with all my heart because it's completely changed my life. It's given me so many opportunities that I don't think our family could have had without it. I'm going to share a big one in just a couple of slides, but I wanted to kind of go over that because I think that knowing the investment is important. So the basic sign up, $39.99 one time, and then it's $15.95 a month. The ideal way to sign up is through a challenge pack. And this I would say is for people that actively want to get going and really want to coach because you get a program, you get Shakeology for 30 days, you get that sign-up fee of $39.99 waived, and you become active status. And that, to do the challenge pack sign-up, it's anywhere from $140 to $180. So most coaches do it that way that are actively wanting to coach so that they become active status. So I wanted to kind of just tell you what that means really quick. But first, I wanted to tell you kind of what a basic earning potential is. So one of my big goals is to help you earn those fees back immediately. Once you become a coach, I want to make it a goal to get those fees back to you as soon as possible. Because like I said, for me, that was a big deal, investing in that. And I wanted to, my husband basically said, you can do this, but you have to earn those fees back. As long as you're making money, as long as you, you know, pay yourself back, then I don't care. You can do whatever. And so for me, that was like an urgent situation. So one of the first things that we teach you is how to do that. So just to give you guys a quick overview, and this is just some of the nitty-gritties with coaching, is for anything you sell, you get 25% commission. But if you sold 3 bags of Shakeology and you helped 3 people a month, that equals your Shakeology paid for, your active status is taken care of every month, and you are your fees are covered. That will pay for all of your coaching fees. So instead of really thinking about the investment, what I want you guys more focused forward on is the people. If you can focus on the people instead of the product, that income will come and it will build. But you have to be focused on the right things first, which is helping people. So if you can commit to helping 3 people a month, you will earn income as a coach, 100%, and I can guarantee that. Active status, I just want to go over this really quick and why it's important. So active status basically just means it establishes you as someone who is actively working to help other people and lift other people's lives. It takes you from being a discount coach, someone who's just doing it for the discount, to a hobby or a career coach, somebody who's actively working to make an income coaching and help people change their life. So in order to be active status, you have to either buy or sell 50 PV or dollars, if that's easier, worth of products, right? Again, that's 100% optional and it's up to you. I recommend every coach that signs up be active status so that you can show that you are committed, you're invested, you have skin in the game, and you are pursuing helping people with a little bit more urgency. That active status really tells Beachbody that you're in this to help people instead of just get a discount on their programs, which you do. You get 25% off all Beachbody products. So the real earning opportunity, and I'll go into this briefly for now because, again, we're just briefly basically talking about what coaching actually is. The earning potential as a coach is 100% up to you. If I put a cap on it, that's what you would believe is the most you could make. If I put a minimum on it, that's the most you would believe you can make. So I don't want to do that. There's no ceiling. There's no financial ceiling with coaching. It 100% depends on what you want to do, what your goals are, and where you're headed. And those are things that we establish right in the beginning. And we help you sort of understand what that means and how to do that. So I don't even want you really worried about that. What I want you guys to think about now is the 3 different kinds of coaches. There's a discount coach who signs up just to get the 25% off the products, and you stay in your coach's challenge group and you do the programs and you love the programs, but you want to save money on them. So you just sign up for a discount coach. We call that being a preferred customer. It's just a great way to save money on Beachbody stuff. It's awesome. A lot of people do it, and a lot of people end up becoming hobby coaches because they love the products so much and they really are helped by their coaches, and it makes them want to pay it forward to somebody else. And that's really what coaching is all about. It's just paying forward what you have done and what you're doing and changing someone's life. Being a hobby coach is really somebody who does it part-time, who likes selling stuff, who wants to kind of dip into the business and start it. And most people that become hobby coaches, I don't even want to say that. Hobby coaches are really just people who actively want to help people, and it just depends on how much time you have to do it. If you want to do it part-time or on the side, that's really what I would say is a hobby coach. Or you can work it like a career and become a full-time fit boss, as I call it, like me. I would say that I started coaching as a hobby coach. I didn't understand the potential or the opportunity to the full degree when I first started coaching. And because I was so focused on helping people and changing my own life, it grew into a career. And it grew into a career quick. And within 8 months of becoming a coach, I quit my job as a hairstylist because it didn't make sense anymore. And I full-time started coaching and have been full-time coaching ever since. I just wanted to share one thing because this was a big victory for me, and it was something that I accomplished with Beachbody financially that I'm really proud of, that I feel like really helped free my family. We had a six-figure debt from our student loans, from our grad program and our undergrads, and you know, it was a big burden on us. It's a big student loan payment to be paying on a six-figure student loan. It's like a freaking mortgage. I honestly don't know how people pay their student loan fees back, because for anybody that has them, they're 15 to 30 year loans, and ours was like paying a mortgage. It was insane. And I remember thinking last January, oh my gosh, we have like this six-figure debt. We have got to get this out of our life. I do not want to be paying on this for the next 30 years. And so I made it a goal from January to June, I was going to pay off that six-figure debt with Beachbody money. And by June, I wasn't quite there yet. But by July, I paid that off. The entire debt gone, eliminated. We set ourselves 30 years ahead, right, by eliminating that debt. It's something we didn't have to pay. That's eliminated and gone from our life. And we basically just got to free ourselves from that burden of paying somebody else and use that money for our future and our potential future investments, and really start doing something with our money for us. And I thought that that was one of the most incredible things. And I say still to this day, if that was the only thing that Beachbody gave me, which it's not, it was worth it 100% to have that one thing eliminated from our life. So the opportunity and the earning potential is something that we dive into, and we really focus on your personal and specific goals, because if we do it any other way, it just won't work, because it doesn't matter what anybody else's goal is that way. Your goals financially are relative to you, and that's it. So for some, they're super big. For some, they're super small. It doesn't really matter. Whatever it is, that's what we want to help you identify and work towards. And that's a really cool thing. The very last objection that I get a lot is ability. I'm not where I want to be physically. I'm not transformed the way that I want to be. I don't have the self-confidence yet. I don't think I can coach people because I'm not even there myself. Honestly, you guys, that's not related to ability. That's related to attitude. And I think understanding that is super important, because absolutely you have the ability to do what we do. 100%. I see it every single day. People who are just like me, who are just like you, who decide to do something different with their life, to dedicate their life to helping other people. And in return, the blessings that you get from that are tenfold. I mean, that karma, you guys, of putting yourself out there every day and adding value to somebody else, I mean, you can't get that kind of karma any other way. You absolutely can do what we do with the right attitude. And that's what that personal development is so important. That's why it's so important to keep that attitude in check, to keep your focus on point, to not get distracted by comparison and by those old demons of I'm not good enough, I'm not there yet, I can't do this, I can't do this. Instead, you don't think about that stuff anymore. You eliminate the fear and you work. That's it, okay? We have focused goals that we're working towards with a structured plan. And just like your health and fitness, and this is something I preach up and down, random results come from random workouts and random diet. It's the exact same formula as your success. Random success comes from random consistency, right? Sometimes plugging in, sometimes not plugging in. Sometimes working, sometimes not working. Okay? If you want predictable results that are in line with your goals, you have to consistently work and stay focused without getting distracted. It's not rocket science. Okay? So that's what my job is. It's to help you stay focused on that. A big part of this, you guys, is the transformation. And I just want to note this because it's so important and it's such a big factor for so many people coming into this. You are the most powerful as a coach when you have somewhere to go. The most. If you came in and said to me, I have this amazing transformation, I'm at my perfect goal weight, I'm ready to go, you have a hard time relating to people. and they have a hard time relating to you. Because at that point, like, if you came to me with that attitude of, I've made it, I'm there, it's like, okay, well, where do you want to go? And they don't know. But if you have a goal and you have somewhere to go, it doesn't matter how fit or unfit you are. It depends on your work ethic and your determination to reach that goal. That's what people are going to grasp onto. That's why they're going to follow you. That's why they're going to fall in love with you. And that's why ultimately they'll be inspired by you to start their own journey. And that's what it's about. So if you're sitting there thinking to yourself, well, I don't look like her, I don't look like him, or I can't do this, or I can't do that, you're going to struggle. You got to get that attitude in check. It's not about that. When you're doing your workouts and you're focusing on your exercise, it's 100% about you. When we're working towards your business goals and what you want to accomplish with coaching, 100% about you. But the instant that a customer or someone reaches out to you for help, you're no longer in the equation. It's 100% about them. They can look at your transformation until they're blue in the face. But at the end of the day, what they care about is their own, right? And if you're somebody that can care about their transformation the way that they do, man, you guys can do a lot of amazing things together. And that is what coaching is. So I want you to focus more on how big your heart is, how willing you are to help the people that come to you, how open you are to sharing your struggles and being real. Because I'll tell you, you guys, the more real you are on social media, the more powerful your impact. I don't hide away from saying I have cheat meals or I sucked today or I made it through 10 minutes of my workout and I was done. Because every time you do something, right, in spite of your excuses, it eliminates somebody else's excuse. They can't look at you and say, well, she's a mom. She just had a baby. She's not sleeping for 7 months, which legit happened to me. My baby didn't sleep for 7 months. But I was still working out. I was still plugging in. I was still focused forward on my journey, my personal progression, and helping other people. So it eliminates that excuse from other people's life. And that's why you do it. So I hope that that helps you see it from a different perspective and the right perspective. Because, yes, this journey is about you, and coaching is a way to elevate your life. And it's such a huge aspect of coaching. But when it comes to you and your customers, it's about them. And I want you to eliminate your fear and your inhibitions and your lack of self-confidence. And I want you to be that person in that moment that you want to be. And that person will grasp onto you and latch onto you and ask you for help. And you'll take them through the journey and we'll teach you how to do that. I want to just remind you guys of those three things. We call them the three vital behaviors. With coaching, they are the key to success. They're how I built my life from living off food stamps to having a six-figure income in a couple years and paying off immense amount of debts and going on vacations and doing all these cool things that I wanted to do with my life. For me, it didn't ever feel like I was in a dire situation where like I needed to financially grow. For me, it was a personal growth. It was an internal transformation. And because I was focused on that and moving forward, the financial part of it just sort of happened. It was just kind of a perk. And that's really the cool part about this, is that it will happen for you if you're doing it the right way. And you don't even have to worry about it because it's inevitable. If you're working diligently every day and staying consistent with these three things, sharing your journey, inviting people to join you, being proactive about this passion that you have to really build an impact, you will build an income. And that is one of the coolest things to be able to do. I helped a single mom pay off her entire mortgage, her mortgage for her house, right? She's a single mom. It's like, okay, all that income that she earns now goes to her son and his education and his life and them doing things together that she never thought was possible. That to me is one of the most incredible gifts that you can give to somebody. It's amazing. These three vital behaviors eliminate any and all excuses that will come up. All of them. They'll eliminate your investment excuse. They'll eliminate your time. And they'll eliminate the I'm not good enough. because you're working in all of those areas to become better every single day. Okay? Last few slides and then we're done. Goals. The people that I invited to this call, I wanted them to sit down and really think out some goals. And the reason is because I think that people set goals based on how much they believe in themselves instead of their actual potential, which is what reality is, right? That's where I come in. That's where your coach comes in. That's where we help you adjust. Because if you only set goals based on how much you believe in yourself, a lot of the times you won't get a lot done until you actually believe in yourself. And so my job is to help you see what you're capable of and see you from the light that I see you in, or that your coach sees you in, or the person that invited you sees you in. Because a lot of the times we can't see that. And I'll tell you guys, my resume that I talked about earlier, that first one of that shy, introverted, pathetic person, that's who I believed I was. But that second set of my resume, the motivated, the hardworking, the dedicated to change, that person is who my coach saw. And that's why I became a coach. And that's how I got from A to B. Okay, it was the borrowed belief that somebody else had in me that consistently said, you can do this, you can do this, you can do this. This is what we're working on, keep going. Okay, that's what coaching is. You adopt the behavior of progression. You adopt the ability to set strong goals and progress in your life. So I want you to go from this call and I want you to think about a financial goal. It can be something that you want to pay off. It can be a vacation you want to take. It can be something you want to buy. It can be a weekly salary, a monthly salary, a yearly salary. It can be anything, but I want you to set a financial goal. Do you know how many people don't set financial goals? If you don't set it, how are you ever going to get better, right? I have this saying, I want you to do all you can do to get it all. There was a personal development bit that my husband showed me a while ago. I don't even remember who it was or what anything that it was about other than this one little piece of it, which was a man talking to his mentor saying, you know, I want to earn this amount of money and I want to do this and I want to do this, but my job only pays me this. And the mentor said, is that all that your company pays? And he said, that's all that my company pays me. And the mentor said, there's other people in your company that make more. Is that right? And he said, yes. And he said, I want you to do it all so that you can get it all. What do you have to do to get it all? And that's what I want to teach you. And the cool thing about this opportunity and Beachbody specifically is that's defined by us. Whatever we decide that number is, or that dream is, or what that event or thing we pay off or whatever that is for us, that's what we can work towards. And that's awesome. Okay, so I want you to set a financial goal. Next, I want you to set a business goal. And I'm saying this for those who are like, yes, I want to do this. I'm gonna sign up as a coach. You're probably crapping in your pants a little bit. Don't mind the language, but it's true. Like, it's a scary kind of thing, but it's exciting. And I want you to set something, a goal that has to do with your progression as far as this business. And you may not know what that is. It may just be, I want to start. I want to pay the fee to get going. Like, it can be as a baby step as you want it. But these are the three goals that I have you set when you start coaching, and we work you through them and we accomplish them. So I want you to kind of think that if you don't have that business goal now, that at some point you will, and we'll get you to that point. The last one is a personal achievement goal, and it's my favorite, because your personal achievement goal is just something that you think would be awesome to do. If you could accomplish this thing this year, you would feel awesome. What is that? You know, it can even be like a bucket list goal. If I could do this year, it would be freaking rad. And it can be as small or as big as you want. I like to give this example to my coaches because I think it's fun. And so I do. Which is, it's super cool to help someone pay off their mortgage or pay their water bill because that's what they need. But it's freaking awesome to help them do something that they want to do, because all of the things that they needed to do are done. You will always work harder for something that you want than something that you need. And I think that that's a really cool thing to be, get you past the part of necessity where you can use coaching and this platform and this meme to advance and further your life and do things you never thought were possible. That's what this is about for me and what I think is so cool. And so that personal achievement goal is like the one that I grab onto and I'm like, yes, let's do that. You know, like I had a call with one of my coaches today, for example, and you know, we set financial goals and we set business goals, but when we talked about that personal achievement goal, it was to take her boys to Disneyland and pay for that on her own without taking from their savings, without anybody saying, you can't use that money. It's money she earned that she 100% made so that she could take her boys to Disneyland. And that one goal fired both of us up more than any of the other ones. So I want you to think of something along the lines of a personal achievement that, you know, maybe you don't even know if it's possible or how to make it happen, but it's something that you just would feel over the moon about accomplishing. Okay? So I want you to write those. You have to know why and what you want and what you're working towards in order to receive how to do it. Okay? And I say receive because this webinar and this opportunity and all these things that I'm saying can fall on deaf ears. Happens all the time. You know, the timing of your life is what you have to trust. And like I said, when I first started, I was ready. The most important thing, it didn't matter how down in the dumps I was or where I was at in my life. In that moment, I was ready. And I went after it and I worked super hard. And I had urgency in changing my life. I didn't want to be that person anymore. I wanted to show my son and myself that I could do it. And so I did. And that is what is so amazing about the opportunity. Here's our last thing, and then I'll let you guys go. From this point, what I want you guys to do, and this is your homework, so if you're smart and you're taking notes, I want you guys to get with your sponsor or the person that invited you to this call, and I want you to tell them what those goals are. And I want you to really sit down and say, this is what I want to do this year. How can we do it? Right? And go over that stuff. I want you to ask any more questions you have about coaching. I want you to decide if this is something for you or not. And then I want you to ask your coach for that sign-up link. And the reason why I say that, because we could send you that and say, here you go, here's how you sign up, here's how you do the basic sign-up, or here's how you do the challenge pack, or whatever. But I want you guys to get to your to the point in your minds where this is your choice, so that when you succeed, it's 100% because of you. And it's yours, and you own it, and you built it from the ground up, and you said yes. You didn't get convinced. Nobody told you that it was what you should do or could do. It was you saying, I'm going to do this. And that little act of commitment alone, you guys, is so important. Every time you commit, you grow. Okay? At that point, if you decide to become a coach, what we do is we welcome you into our team as a new CEO, like I said, new fit boss, right? We plug you into our group support page. So you have 24/7 support, no matter what. We set you up, we get you going, we literally hold your hand through the whole process, we goal set, and then we plug you into the liftoff training, and you go for it. The liftoff training is the how. You know why, you know what it is. The liftoff is how you do it. It's literally how I grew my business online from zero. Zero followers, zero friends, zero network, zero everything, right? To what it is today, which is a fitness empire that basically allows me to work because I love it. I don't have to worry about time. We don't have to worry about the financial part of it. All I'm doing is what I love. And that's ultimately what I want for all of my coaches and the people that come into our family, because, you know, that's really what this is all about. We're all just trying to make it, right? We're all just doing that. And if we can do it and we can come together, then we can do it faster and we can do it better. And we can teach you how not to make the same mistakes that we did. And that liftoff training gives you the how. It teaches you everything you need to know to build a successful business as a coach. And it's awesome. So I want you to feel confident about that process. In closing, I just want you guys to think about a couple things. Success is such a funny thing, and it's so relative to your own personal wants and desires and what your definition of success is. The people that can remain focused consistently over time. And I want you guys to write this down because this is so important. I want you to think about it. The people that remain focused consistently over time, who don't allow themselves to be distracted by the common excuses, right, that everybody else is setting, are the ones that set themselves apart and succeed. Most people live their life unintentionally. They live their life without a purpose. They live their life at a 5 or a 10% capacity, just making it through the day, right? If you guys can just do it even like 1% more and just be a little different and do something that most people aren't, right? Just a little bit. Think how much further you can take your life and your journey. Don't be that person that gets distracted, okay? In 2016, I want you guys to work on those goals. I want you to do something bigger with your life. I want you to fulfill that little burning in your belly of, I should be doing more. I need to get my crap together. I need to do this, or I want to do this. This is the time. There's no better time than now to not waste time anymore. Okay? Get with your sponsors, go over your goals, ask your questions, and let's get after it. We have a really amazing opportunity this year. Our team is gunning for a top team in our entire organization this year, and it would be awesome to be able to bring you guys on and help us do that. We need you. We need, you know, your energy and your spirit and your dedication to really get after this opportunity. So I will let you guys go. Thank you for hopping on. I have a couple people on the chat. If you guys have questions, feel free to answer them. But please, please, please get with the person that invited you and go over your thoughts while it's fresh on your mind, even if you think they're asleep, and let's get you guys at it, and we'll have a good year together. And I will talk to you guys soon. Thanks so much for hopping on.